Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you a little bit about how to use NDI with Unreal Engine. NDI is a way of sending a high quality video over your home network or over Wi-Fi, and it's a good substitute for cables in some cases. It lets you use your phone as well as other different kinds of camera gadgets. A lot of people have done tutorials on these, but I've noticed that many of them are rather out of date. And I also noticed the NDI docs are a little bit out of date as well. So I thought you would appreciate having something current that shows you how to do this. The one thing that most people don't show you is how to output to NDI from Composure. This is kind of useful because it would let you take, say, a virtual production studio that you've set up and output to NDI so that you can display it in something like a video chat like Zoom or Teams. I'm going to talk about that first because very few people have, and then I'll follow on and show you how to get NDI inputs as well. One of the issues with the older NDI stuff was that you had to compile some things in order to use it, and a lot of people weren't real comfortable with that. It looks like the latest version, you could just install and it'll work with 4.25 or 4.26 of Unreal, and that's all. You don't need to compile anything, so that helps a lot. I'm going to show you how to do this in my VP Studio sample project, but odds are if you're doing anything with virtual production, your project will have a similar Composure setup, so the examples I'm going to show you will apply there as well. So the first thing you need to do is get the NDI tools for Unreal, and they're all on the site ndi.tv. The first thing you want to do is go to the NDI Tools page, and if you scroll down to the bottom, you'll see NDI Tools for Windows, and you'll want to download that and install it. The second thing you want to do is go to the SDK page, scroll down to the bottom, and download the NDI SDK for Unreal Engine. Now you've got everything that you need to get started. Just go ahead and install both of those packages. What you're seeing are two of the tools from NDI Tools on the screen, and you want to have these up and running because it'll make your life a lot easier testing this out. You won't have to worry about whether your camera's working right or anything like that if you use these. The tool on the left is called Test Patterns, and it lets you pick a pattern such as some kind of color bars or color sweeps like this. The tool on the right is called the NDI Studio Monitor, and it's receiving whatever you send with an NDI camera or with this test patterns program. And you can see up to the top of the studio monitor here, it says the name of the camera or the name of the source. And anytime you, if you have more than one, you can come up here to your computer name and select it from here. But for right now, what we want to do is we want to start up test patterns and probably pick the normal test pattern. For now, we won't do too much with the studio monitor. I'll get to that shortly. So after you've installed NDI tools in the Unreal NDI SDK, the first thing you need to do is go in Unreal in Settings and Plugins, and you need to find the NDI plugin and turn it on. This is it. You just check the box and say restart. So the first thing I recommend you do is create a couple of folders for your NDI input and output objects. I've just done that here already to save some time, and I'll open up the NDI output one now. So since we want to output the final comp as NDI, the first thing we need to do is set up that output. So I'm going to click on VP Studio Comp. Your comp may be named something different, but whatever is the final comp object, that's where you'll find this stuff. Go down in details until you see outputs, and you probably already have something here. What we need to do is set up a render target output. Then we need to open up the output pass and actually create a new render target. Make sure you use render target and not canvas render target. And we're going to save that in the NDI output folder. And I'll just name that comp output. Okay, now that's all set. Now we need to create an NDI media sender object. You won't be able to see this quite as well in this capture, but if you right click and then you choose media, and then on the media list, there'll be NDI media sender. And when you're done, it'll look like that. So I'm going to call that NDI comp output. Now we just have to set up that object. So I'll double click to open it. And you can see here our source name. This is the name that your output will appear under. And I'm just going to leave it Unreal Engine output. The things here on frame size, that's pretty self-explanatory. I'm going to set my frame rate down to 30 frames. Actually, I think I'll set it to 24 frames. And then you need to set your render target to the one that you just made called comp output. The last thing you need to do is set up your project to actually start the NDI transmission. To do that, you're going to need to add some blueprint to either your level blueprint or to the player controller blueprint. Now, in the case of my VP Studio project, I have a player controller blueprint already, so I'm going to go and add it to that. So that's down here in VP Studio Core under VP Player Controller. And if you've looked at this before, you can see it's pretty darn big and complicated, but don't let that scare you because what we're going to add is really pretty small. So in the case of my VP Studio, I'm going to just add another pin here. Then up here in Components, I'm going to click and add an NDI broadcast component. Now I'll get a pointer to NDI broadcast out here and drag it out and tell it I want to start broadcasting. And we'll connect that to the pin here, which as you can see, it'll be the last thing we execute when event begin play comes along. The last thing you might want to do is get a little bit of error reporting in here just so that you know everything is starting up right. So I'm going to move this over and this down a little bit. And what I'm going to do is say, let's take the return value and say branch. And if the branch is true, we'll just print NDI has started. Okay, and I'll leave that there. And then in the case we have an error, what we'll do is we'll say print string again, and we'll take the error message and print that. So to test, all I need to do is come up to the main Unreal toolbar and hit play, and you'll see I've got an error message. Just showed up briefly there. And I intentionally left an error in so you could see that the error message code actually works. To fix this error, we go back to the player controller, click on NDI broadcast, and the thing that was missing was we didn't associate it with our NDI output component. So I'll do that now. Compile again, go back to the main map, and say play, and you can see it now says NDI has started briefly. Now this would be a lot more interesting if there was something more on the screen, so I will click in there and hit I to get inspection mode in my VP Studio template. If you've got something different running, you'll have to do that yourself. And then I'll hit Shift F1 and I'll also click on the VP Studio comp. So when what should be happening right now is the image we see here in this little window should be getting sent out NDI, but how do we find out if that's actually working? Well, that's where the NDI Studio Monitor tool comes in. You should be able to click here, look at your computer and see Unreal Engine output there now. And when I select it, it comes up black. And that's the last thing that we're going to have to fix. I was actually stuck here for a bit until I figured out the trick. Just go back to the NDI output folder you created and double click on the render target that you made. And then if you look over here in render target format, it says that it's an RGB format with 16-bit floating point, which is unfortunately not compatible with NDI. So I'm going to change it to RGBA8 sRGB. And the moment I made that change, my NDI Studio monitor lit up, and you can see that it's now showing VP Studio comps. Same basically thing as the comp is outputting. And that is everything you need to do in order to get your Composure final comp output to come out on NDI. From there, you can use any NDI receiving program, including things like Zoom and Teams, to pick up and display or use that output video. Now I'll show you how to use NDI as an input to Composure. First thing, to make testing easy, I start up the test pattern program and I just selected one of the color bar patterns like this. That'll provide me an NDI source on my computer without having to have a camera all set up. And I go back to the NDI input folder we made earlier, and we'll get started. So the first thing we need is to create an NDI input source. So we go down and pop this up. Sorry you can't see this, but if you go down to Media, you'll find an item on there called NDI Media Receiver. And now we've made that, and I'll just rename that slightly to NDI Media Receiver. And then we need to set this up a little bit, so we double click on it. And you'll see where it says video texture, there's nothing, so just click on that and say I want an NDI media video texture. And let's save that as NDI media texture in the NDI receiver folder that we just had, we're working in. Now again, we need to add a little bit of blueprint code to the player controller to actually start up the receiver. So I'm gonna go into VP Studio Core and into my player controller. This is the stuff we added a minute ago. And I'm gonna be a little sloppy here. I'll just add another pin, and then we'll come up to add component up here and add an NDI receiver component. And we'll drag one of those out into the blueprint down here. The setup for this is very similar to when we were doing the broadcaster. We'll want to click on the receiver and we'll say the NDI media source is the NDI media receiver we just made. Now I'll just right click in the blueprint and say I want find network source by name and create that. And I will connect that up to the pin we created up here so that this will be run when we start the game up. And I'll move this a little bit to make it a little easier to follow. And I'll add a bit of error checking to this. So I'll take the return value and do a branch. And if it's true, for the moment, I'll just print source found. And if it's false, I'll say print source not found. Then all we need to do is go over to the find network source by name that we already made and fill the correct source name in. You can see mine is kind of long and weird, and the way you find out the exact source name you need, you already started the test pattern generator. So now if you go into your NDI Studio monitor, you should see the test pattern. And when you select it, you'll see here it says the name. This is the actual name of the NDI stream right here. And I just copied that over into find network source by name, and I'm all set to go. Now I'll give this a quick test by hitting play, and you can say it says source found. So we're in good shape. Now all we have to do is start receiving. So I'm going to move my NDI receiver guy over here. And pull out a wire and say start receiver. And connect this up. And at this point, if you wanted to, you could add some more error checking here. I'm not going to, just to keep things simple. And the last thing we need to do is come back to the find network source by name and get the connection information and connect that up. Now all I have to do is connect that to my media plate in my Composure setup, and I'm ready to use the video. So I go up and I click on my media plate. And what I need to do here is set up my media source to be pointed at my texture. And what you have to do to make that work is come up to media source and change it from media texture compositing input to just texture input. And then you should be able to find it. If I just go NDI media texture 2D. And now you can see it's displaying the same thing that the test pattern generator is sending. Of course, you'll notice the green bar is missing. That's because in my setup here, chroma key is already on. So that green bar is keyed out. And that's basically everything you need to know to get this working. I hope this was useful. Let me know if you have any trouble using it.